Hello friends, welcome to the lecture series of history by Brainy IAS. In this lecture series we are discussing about the medieval India. In my previous lectures you might have heard about the medieval India and the classification. This lecture I shall not be going into the entire description of medieval India and its classification. I will be continuing my lecture from the previous lecture. In my previous lecture we have talked about this Delhi Sultanate. In Delhi Sultanate we have covered Mamluks, first one. We have covered Mamluks. Then after Mamluks there were Khaljis. Khalji, K-H-A or K-H-L-G-I, one and same thing. Mamluks, Khalji, Tughlaq. So we have covered about these three things. After that we have learned that the individual came to India was the Temurlung. Somewhere around we reached here in the 1398. So in 1398 the last Tughlaq ruler Nasir Muhammad Tughlaq was there. Nasir Muhammad Tughlaq was there, who was attacked by Temurlung. Temur invasion took place and he defeated him, and after he defeated him all the dynasties in India were spread, or all the individuals who could make their own dynasty, they started making their own dynasties. And Temurlung remained in India. After coming to India he just came for one purpose, that is for the plundering of this country and nothing more than that. So he plundered this country and in Delhi, not country but Delhi specifically, and he ruined the Delhi, and Delhi was full of, you can say, according to the texts we can say Delhi was full of death and blood around the cities and the streets. So he plundered mercilessly Delhi, and after that he returned back to his native place. Now when he returned back to his native place, after that came the Sayyids. So Sayyid were the next one. Now before coming to Sayyid, I would like to take your interest into the another aspect, that when Tughlaq or you can say when Tughlaq dynasty ended, then in South India or in the central part of the India, this entire part of India, the new kingdoms were also emerged. The two new kingdoms that emerged over here is the Vijayanagar Empire. Vijayanagar Empire, and second one is the Bahmani. See, just remember, Bahmani is the Muslim Empire, Vijayanagar is the Hindu Empire. So yaad rakhiyega, Vijay from Vijay, it is the Hindu, and Bahmani is Muslim. So yahan se hamare paas do aur aa jati hain after this Tughlaqs. So before going into the details of Vijayanagar Empire and Bahmani Empire, we shall be going into the details of this two more dynasties, that is the Sayyid and Lodis. A quick overview of Sayyids and the Lodis. The Sayyids ki agar main baat karta hoon, then Khizr Khan took advantage. Khizr Khan was the individual. Sayyid ki baat kar raha hoon to Khizr Khan. Khizr Khan was an individual who was ruling Multan. Multan ko rule kar raha tha, and from Multan he came back to India. He took the advantage that no one was ruling Delhi, so he tried to occupy the throne of Delhi. So he occupied the throne of Delhi and he started ruling, and he started the foundation of the Sayyid dynasty. After that, two kings are important. There is a Mubarak Shah and Muhammad Shah. Mubarak Shah and Muhammad Shah. So Mubarak Shah and Muhammad Shah is important. Why Mubarak Shah is important? First is he was the individual who established, or you can say, you know, ek shahar basaya, Mubarakabad. So Mubarakabad is important. He was the first individual to appoint Hindu to the royal court. So he was the first individual to be appointed in the royal court, and after that he was murdered. So he after he was murdered. He was the next individual. There was the Muhammad Shah. Muhammad Shah ko ke bare mein agar hum baat karte hain, to Muhammad Shah was not that much great as the case of the Khizr Khan or Mubarak Shah. Muhammad Shah was important in the case because while his expeditions, one of the individual, that is the Behlol, B-A-H-L-O-L, Behlol Lodi, rendered him the help. Behlol Lodi ne isko help kari, and after that Behlol Lodi was given the title of Khan-e Khanan. Khan, this title is important. This can be asked in small exams, not in the big exams. So Khan-e Khanan title was given to the Behlol Lodi. After this, the successors were very weak, and later on Lodis came, primarily the Behlol Lodi came to the throne of the Delhi. So with this, the Sayyid dynasty ends and comes the Lodi dynasty. Now Sayyid dynasty ke baad Behlol Lodi was an individual who came to the throne. इसके भलो लोदी की बात खास क्या थी? He always knew that the power or the welfare of the noble. So he always took care of every each and every noble in his court. He never sat on his throne. Rather than he sat in front of the throne just to make the people feel or just to make the nobles feel that he is one of them. Important thing of भलो लोदी or the लोदी dynasty is Agra. They built Agra. आगरा सिटी लोदी की सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन है. अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट ही वॉज वेरी मच यू कैन से स्ट्रिक्ट रूलर एंड ही वॉज यू कैन से एंजॉयड. हाँ, देयर इज वन मोर थिंग दैट ही एंजॉयड शहनाई. शहनाई इसने एंजॉय की थी एंड आफ्टर दैट ही वॉज वन ऑफ द ग्रेट रूलर्स ऑफ दिस लोदी डायनेस्टी. आफ्टर दैट केम द इब्राहिम लोदी. द नेक्स्ट इंडिविजुअल इज द इब्राहिम लोदी. इब्राहिम लोदी आए. इब्राहिम लोदी भाई साहब की खास बात क्या थी? इनकी खास बात यह थी कि ही वॉज वेरी अनकॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग, टॉलरेंट, मतलब किसी चीज को कभी भी टॉलरेट नहीं करता था. थर्ड थिंग इंपॉर्टेंट वॉज ही वॉज वेरी यू कैन से सरकास्टिक और नॉट सरकास्टिक बट ही ह्यूमिलेटेड पीपल विद अ फुल इंटरेस्ट. सो लोगों को ह्यूमिलेट करता था, अपने नोबल्स को ह्यूमिलेट करता था. एंड व्हेन द दिलावर खान लोदी, दिलावर खान लोदी वॉज ह्यूमिलेटेड, हु वॉज द सन ऑफ दौलत खान लोदी. और जब इसको ह्यूमिलेट किया गया, देन दौलत खान लोदी वेंट टू बाबर एंड इन्वाइटेड हिम टू इंडिया टू टेक रिवेंज फ्रॉम दिस. देन बाबर केम टू इंडिया एंड बाबर हैड अ फाइट इन 1526. बाबर हैड अ फाइट विद दिस इंडिविजुअल एंड आफ्टर दैट द रूल ऑफ बाबर started in India or Mughal started in India. So with this, the entire, you can say, this slave dynasty comes to an end. But before ending this slave dynasty, we'll be going to the Vijayanagar and Bahmani kingdom. A small review of the Vijayanagar and Bahmani kingdom. Vijayanagar empire was started by two individuals. One is the Harihara and Bukka. Harihara and Bukka were the individuals who were under the Hoysala king Veer Balala III. Veer Balala III ke andar Hoysalas ke andar ye king se. After that they seek their independence or independence ke baad wo chal pade. So these individuals started establishing their own area under the saints. Aur saint ke baad they occupied the area south of this Tungabhadra. साउथ ऑफ तुंगभद्रा में इन्होंने अपना एरिया बनाना शुरू कर दिया. आफ्टर मेकिंग द एरिया ऑफ साउथ ऑफ तुंगभद्रा, दे मेड द कैपिटल एज कैपिटल हम्पी. हम्पी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द आर्किटेक्चरल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, फ्रॉम द आर्किटेक्चरल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. सो हम्पी वॉज द कैपिटल ऑफ विजयनगर एम्पायर. ठीक है, याद रखिएगा हम्पी के लिए. अनदर थिंग, विजयनगर एम्पायर वॉज डिवाइडेड इन टू, or you can say there were different dynasties, as we have seen in the Magad Empire also had different dynasties. Same was the case with the Vijayanagar Empire also had the different dynasties. First dynasty being the Sangama dynasty, S A N GAMA, Sangma dynasty. After Sangma dynasty, we have Saluva dynasty. Saluva dynasty. After Saluva dynasty, we have Tuluva dynasty. Tuluva dynasty. And last, we have Aravidu dynasty. So these are the few dynasties, sorry, these are not five dynasties, but these are the four dynasties that are important. And amongst these dynasties, Sangma dynasty, Saluva dynasty, Tuluva dynasty, and Aravidu dynasty, all these dynasties constituted to the Vijayanagar Empire. A Vijayanagar Empire in panch dynasties se banta tha. Important rulers of this Vijayanagar Empire, the important rulers of Vijayanagar Empire is Harihara, first one, Harihara. Then Bukka, ये दोनों के दोनों founder थे of this empire. Then Harihara II and Devarya. Harihara II, Devarya I and II, and last one was the Krishan Devarya. See, this Krishan Devarya is important ruler because अगर मैं बात करता हूँ Krishan Devarya, this Tuluva dynasty से एक important ruler था, that was Krishan Dev Arya. Krishan Dev Arya was an important ruler. Why it was important ruler? Because he consolidated entire region. Like he conquered Sivasamudram. Sivasamudram को इसने conquer किया था, constructed number of tanks between and the area between इसने he conquered Siva Samudram. He constructed tanks इसने बनाए थे, canals इसने बनाई थी. Apart from making tanks and canals, he also had a very cordial relationships with the Portuguese and the Arabs. Arabs और Portuguese के साथ इसके बहुत अच्छे relationship थे. He maintained a very cordial relationship between them and the area between Kaveri and Krishna. And Krishna used to come under it. So Kaveri and Krishna ke beech ka jitna bhi area tha isne liya tha. Theek hai. After that, what is important is the successors of this individual, that is the Krishna Devarya, were weak. And this is important to mention the Battle of Talikota. The Battle of Talikota. Now, what is this Battle of Talikota? As the successors of Krishan Devarya were very weak, so what happened during the reign of Ram Arya के time, ये जितने भी लोग थे, ये सारे के सारे Battle of Talikota में मिले. सारे लोग कौन? The individual from the other states like Bijapur, Ahmednagar, Golconda, इन सारे एरियाज से इकट्ठे हुए, एंड बिदर ऑल्सो, इन एरिया से ये लोग इकट्ठे हुए, एंड दे फॉट अगेंस्ट दिस विजयनगर एम्पायर, एंड विजयनगर एम्पायर वॉज टोटली मर्सीलेसली वॉज यू कैन से रिमूव फ्रॉम द पेजेस ऑफ द हिस्ट्री. सो विजयनगर एम्पायर केम टू एन एंड. Something important with respect to Vijayanagar Empire, Vijayanagar Empire also had one more thing, that is the administrative structure. Vijayanagar Empire had a very good administrative structure with the entire area was divided into six parts, and amongst those six parts, the head was known as the Nayak. Nayak was further having the distribution of areas with the districts and the villages. Villages used to have their local administration, and in the local administration, they used to local duties and responsibilities to take on. Second thing is the women position. During Vijayanagar Empire, no doubt the girls were allowed to educate themselves and everything, but the child marriage was prevalent, sati system was prevalent during that phase, and no doubt girls were enjoying a good position in the society. And revenue, the main source of revenue for the Vijayanagar Empire was land revenue. So land was very meticulously, you can say, surveyed upon, because it generated a large number of good number of revenue. And the judiciary was also at its max, and everything was perfect in this case. So this was the Vijayanagar Empire. Corresponding to this, we have Bahmani Kingdom. Now, Bahmani Kingdom is important. Why? Because this is a Muslim kingdom of South. And why this is important? Because as you have studied in the earlier lecture of Tughlaq, that he shifted the capital from North to Devagiri in the South, or Devagiri or Daulatabad. Now, if they started there, shifted their capital to Daulatabad, and after that, they again shifted their capital to the North. And in the North, they have shifted their capital to Delhi back. Now, as they have shifted their capital to the South, after shifting the capital to the South, some of the Muslims remained over there. And when these Muslims remained over there, in the due course of time, when this Tughlaq era ended, they rose to power and they started making their own kingdom. And in this, the Hasan Ganga Bahmani was the first individual. So, according to the Muslims' movement towards the South, this led to the formation of one more new Muslim kingdom, that is the Bahmani Kingdom. And in Bahmani Kingdom, the individual who started this was the Hasan Ganga Bahmani. Hasan Ganga Bahmani. Hasan Ganga Bahmani was the first individual. So, after that, we have Muhammad Shah 1 and Muhammad Shah 2. In the Muhammad Shah 1 defeated Muhammad Shah 1 and Muhammad Shah 2. During Muhammad Shah 2, peace prevailed in the entire region. And after that, we have Firoz Shah Bahmani, who defeated Dev Arya 1. Who defeated Dev Arya 1. So he defeated Dev Arya 1. Muhammad Shah 1 defeated Bukka 1 of Vijayanagar. Bukka 1 of Vijayanagar. So these were the Vijayanagar empires, or you can say Vijayanagar kings, who were in the continuous struggle with the Bahmani and Bahmani Kingdom. So these were the important. Apart from it, Muhammad Shah 3 is important. Before Muhammad Shah, it is Ahmad Shah, which is important. Ahmad Shah. Ahmad Shah was a very cruel leader, and in the battle, when he was very cruel and merciless ruler, he shifted the capital from Gulbarg to Bidar. Just remember, from Gulbarg to Bidar, the capital was shifted. Now, as the capital was shifted from Gulbarg to Bidar, so it has no such aspect or economical impact. So another thing was, he died at a very early age, and after his death, his 9-year-old son, the Muhammad Shah 3, came to power. Muhammad Shah 3 came to power. When Muhammad Shah 3 came to power, he was at the age of 9, and he was having his regent as Muhammad Gawan. Muhammad Gawan uska dhyan rakhta tha. Theek hai? So initially Muhammad Gawan was there. So during their reign, the entire Bahmani kingdom rose to the power, and it was very much, you can say, influential, and it covered the areas up to the south of discovery, or pure is area pe inhone cover kiya, and they consolidated very efficiently the empire. After Muhammad Gawan, what happened, that Muhammad Gawan, when he was in the court, he was falsely implicated into or fabricated into the crime, and after that he was given death sentence by Muhammad Shah himself. So after this Bahmani kingdom, this entire Bahmani kingdom was divided into further 5 kingdoms. Those 5 kingdoms are Bijapur, Bidar, and then we have Bijapur, Bidar, Berar, Ahmednagar, and Golconda, which led to the end of Bahmani kingdom. So these Bahmani kingdom and Vijayanagara empire, these are important. These are the areas of this location. These are important, and these are important for the art and architecture purposes very much. So with this, I finish my lecture on this Vijayanagara and Bahmani kingdom. I shall be taking up the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and keep following the books provided by the academy. Thank you. Thank you very much, friends.